Hello, today we're going to be talking about mouthpieces for the bass clarinet that cost under $70. I was originally shooting for a mouthpiece video where I was going for under 100, but I found a whole bunch of them that are under 70 bucks, so we'll talk about those. Now, these are mouthpieces for people who are starting the bass clarinet, so these are student mouthpieces. They're for people who are picking the instrument up and aren't quite sure whether they want to go ahead and spend $150 and up for a professional mouthpiece. But let me just say right now, off the bat, if you're starting the bass clarinet and you can afford to buy a mouthpiece for $160, $170 rather than something that's $70 or $20, as you will see, it's probably a good idea because that mouthpiece will carry you so much further. You won't have to switch mouthpieces, I don't know, after 2 years or something like that when you outgrow one of these, and you will outgrow them. So if you can afford it and you feel like it's something that you're probably going to stick with for a little while, it's best for you probably to just go ahead and pick up a professional mouthpiece. Now, I wouldn't go crazy and spend, you know, $400, $500, $600 on a mouthpiece. You can get a really good mouthpiece for under $200. But for those of you who aren't sure, for those of you who don't think you're going to be playing bass clarinet for all that long, for those of you who have a bass clarinet at school where the mouthpiece has a big gouge out of it, or you just want your own mouthpiece that no one else is putting their mouth on, this is the video for you. So, without further ado, let's get started talking about inexpensive bass clarinet mouthpieces. Right, so these are a bunch of mouthpieces that I have never played. I don't even have cork grease on them yet. I'm gonna have to do that, actually. I have washed them all. And by the way, when you get a new mouthpiece, please wash it. That's disgusting. You're gonna put it in your mouth if you haven't washed it. No, just take a little soap and water and cold water and go ahead and just wash it and wipe it, just pat it dry before you play it. Thank you. This is the Clark Phobes debut mouthpiece. Clark Phobes is a manufacturer of very, very good professional mouthpieces, and this is Clark Phobes' student mouthpiece called the debut, appropriately. Next is the Premier by Height. Are you seeing sort of a pattern with the mouthpiece names? The Premier as in the first, as in your first mouthpiece. David Height is another mouthpiece manufacturer that makes professional mouthpieces, and this is David Height's student mouthpiece. Next up here, we have the Bundy from Conn-Selmer. The Conn-Selmer Bundy 3 mouthpiece. I haven't tried that one in about 45 years, but I used to play on one of those. This is the venerable Yamaha 4C. The 4C is probably a mouthpiece that you're familiar with. If you have a mouthpiece that is in your bass clarinet case that is not yours, chances are it is a Yamaha 4C. Okay, and then next up is Jupiter. Jupiter makes student bass clarinets, and Jupiter is the only mouthpiece that came with a mouthpiece cap and ligature. Of course, they're not great, but you got one, so you don't have to buy one separately. So that's something to think about if it's good. Finally, on your right here is a no-name brand mouthpiece that I found on Amazon for $20, made in China. Though I think probably all of these are manufactured in China, but this one was $21. It was the cheapest one I could find. And we will see what this one sounds like. I'm already afraid. Oh my gosh, I'm already afraid of it. But we'll get to that last. Okay. I have a bunch of reeds here. I have no idea what reed will fit on this mouthpiece, but I can tell you that the mouthpiece and the reed need to go together. You can't say, well, I'm gonna try a mouthpiece with the reed that I have, because that reed may not fit the mouthpiece that you have. And what do I mean by fit? Well, reed strengths have everything to do with how far the mouthpiece curves away from the reed. That's called the facing of the mouthpiece. There's a tip opening, and then the mouthpiece curves away from the reed. The reed is straight, hopefully, and the mouthpiece will curve. If the mouthpiece curves away far, you're going to need a softer reed because it has to travel further to vibrate. So the strength of your reed is not the content of your character. I have met so many people who say, well, I play on a 3.5 reed and you play on a 2.5 reed, so that makes me one better than you. Wrong! Yeah, it just means you have a mouthpiece that is closer so you can play a heavier reed. Either that or you have a mouthpiece that's really wide open and you sound like butt. So, at any rate, we're going to have to match our reeds to the mouthpiece, and that's why I have a ton of them here on a bunch of different strengths. So first up, let's give the Clark Phobes debut a blow. Okay, so I've got the Clark Phobes debut mouthpiece, and here I have a number 3 reed that I've been soaking for a minute, and I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to try the 3 reed first. Why a number 3 reed? The number 3 is a pretty middle of the road reed. I personally, on my B50, Van Doren B50, which is a really wide open mouthpiece, so I need a really soft reed, I play a 2.5. But since these are student mouthpieces, I'm going to guess that a 3 is a good one to start with. I can always go up a half strength or down a half strength. So this is the Phobes mouthpiece, and again, it is $56. Thank you.
on the reed.
But you know, I feel like this mouthpiece, compared to what I'm used to, is really close. It's not a terrible thing for a student to have a mouthpiece that is a little bit closer so they don't have to push the reed so hard. But I would bet that if this is your first mouthpiece, this reed, even though it's a number three and it feels about right to me, is going to be a little bit too hard for you to get a sound on. So I'm gonna crack open a 2.5. So this is a 2.5 Van Doren. Again, I'm doing this because as a student, you're probably not gonna have the embouchure built up that I have over 40 years. You're gonna be starting with an embouchure that you've built up over 2 minutes. So let's see if this does anything better. And I'm gonna do my best to channel my inner fourth grader to see if I can get a fourth grade embouchure. That sounds like it'd be a lot better with this Phobes as a 2.5. Actually, it's better for me too. Hey, actually, that sounds much better than the 3. So the Phobes works really well with the 2.5. Let me go ahead now and try this Juno. It's a Van Doren Juno reed. Number 3. Now, Juno reeds are student reeds. They're a lot less expensive. This is Van Doren's answer to the Rico Brown box, you know, the basic Rico reed, student reed. So this is a number 3. And the reason I'm going to a number 3 on this is that these run so much softer than the traditional Van Doren reeds. So it's not a match. The 3 traditional and the 3 Juno are not the same 3. Probably be something that's easier for somebody who's young to play. You might even go to a 2.5. Yeah, I think if I went to a 2.5 in the Juno, I'd be courting disaster. But, you know, as long as we're here. Fourth grader. Yeah, it doesn't take a lot of air. It certainly doesn't take a lot of embouchure. And as soon as you start getting an embouchure that's a little bit more formed, you're going to need to move up to a reed like the Juno 3 or the Van Doren 2.5. So the Phobes mouthpiece, though, let me put that 2.5 back on and play something. Yeah, so it's a little bit on the soft side here, this Van Doren 2.5 on the Phobes, but it's a good sounding mouthpiece, actually. So, the Phobes at $56, yes, it's the first one I've tried, but it's not bad at all. Actually, it's pretty good. So, all right, let's move on now to the David Height Premier. It is $36, so it's about, I don't know, 35, 40% less expensive than the Clark Phobes, so let's just give this a try. Okay, so it's a lot closer of a mouthpiece. It's gonna take a much harder reed than this 3, I think, but let's start with this 3. All right, low embouchure. Yeah, it's very resistant. In the upper register, even with this 3. Let me try a 3.5. Again, I think a 3.5 for a brand new student is kind of bonkers. I don't think I would ever recommend it, but you know, since we're here. Yeah, there is not a single player who would be able to make that work, but it sounds better on a 3.5, but literally there is no beginner that I could possibly imagine that would be able to get that going. All right, so let me go to the 2.5. So this is the one that worked well on the Clark Phobes. Sorry. I'm not a fan of this Premier. I don't think I would recommend it. All right. Sorry. Moving on. Next up is the Selmer Bundy mouthpiece. It clocks in at the second most expensive. It is $67. And I've got the traditional Van Doren number 3 reed on it. I'm gonna start with my my looser embouchure. I keep saying my fourth grade embouchure because I started the clarinet in fourth grade, so that's why I'm trying to channel that. That was when I began my love/hate affair with reeds and mouthpieces. Okay, so I'm having to put a lot of pressure on the back side of the reed, which is something that a young student is not going to really have the strength to do. So I'm pushing on the reed sort of right in the middle of it to get a sound out, which means the facing of this mouthpiece is pretty long, which means that the curve goes a long way. So sometimes the curves are like just at the tip, sometimes they go a little bit further. This has kind of a long feeling facing, which means that the reed itself is too hard at the back end of the mouthpiece. So I'm just pushing on the back of the reed right here to push it closer to the mouthpiece. And as I do that, the sound comes into focus. Here, listen. Now there's no way you're gonna have a ligature that can push that up there. So this reed and this mouthpiece are a bad match. It's also possible that this mouthpiece is not a good match for anything. That was the Van Doren 3, let's try the 2.5. The 2.5 is gonna be a lot lighter at the tip, but it's also gonna be a lot lighter everywhere else. That means that it might solve this problem on the back of the reed where the facing gets long, but it could be that the tip is too soft then for it to make a decent articulation. So let's see. With me pushing. It's a decent sound when I push there. So when I play it in the clarion register, it pinches off because, again, in order for me to get a sound, I have to push harder on the reed because of the long facing. But when I push harder on the reed, it closes the tip off so the tip won't vibrate. So if I go to a softer reed, it's just gonna make the situation worse. This is the Juno Strength 3. Yeah, whenever I exert more strength in my embouchure to get the sound out, it closes off. I'm gonna say also a no for this Bundy 3. Again, that was a waste of $67. Next is the Yamaha 4C, and I'm opening up a new reed for this one because I was sort of pushing on that last one to get the three to work. And since that might have done something to the integrity of the reed as I was really shoving on it pretty hard to make the sound come out, I just want to give the Yamaha a fair shake. So I broke open a new number three reed to give that one a try. It's got a really kind of meh sound here. Yeah, again, this is another facing that feels long. Before I go ahead and ruin this reed, I'm gonna put the one that I just played on the Bundy back on it, because I think I have to do the same push on the 4C to make this work. I'm gonna move my ligature up a little bit so it gives the pressure a little bit closer to the tip of the reed, but obviously I can't go onto the part of the reed that has the cut, because first of all, the ligature won't hold, and second of all, that's not where a ligature goes. But I've pushed it up as far as I can in order to give more pressure on that part of the reed. Oh, that's actually even worse. Okay, so this Yamaha is $47, and I am super unimpressed with it, I'm sorry to say. Let me try on a 2.5. It takes almost no embouchure at all, and as soon as you have any embouchure going on this reed, it closes off. I'm gonna do my best to make the best sound I can. Of mouthpieces, the reed going from one mouthpiece facing to the next mouthpiece facing to the next is going to kind of give the reed a little bit of shock, right? Because the reed is having to vibrate in a different way in order to accommodate how you have to play that mouthpiece to make it sound like anything. So the reed itself is a little confused. So I want to just start with a reed that is not confused to see if it's the reed orbits the mouthpiece. So this is another 2.5 Van Doren traditional. Yeah, so this is better than that other 2.5 that I have. I'm going to keep that one aside. But still, this mouthpiece is really, really inflexible. As soon as you push air through it, it closes off. Doesn't matter the strength of the reed. The reed itself, as soon as you get some air going through it, the tip of it closes. So it makes it really, really resistant and hard to play. All right. I am 1 for 4. Let's move ahead to the Jupiter. Let me go ahead and grab the Jupiter's ligature since I feel like I owe it to Jupiter since Jupiter sold it to me with a ligature to give it a try. So next up is the Jupiter. Here I am struggling with Jupiter's ligature again. Okay, so let me tighten this up. Oh God. It won't even, you know what? I can't wait to step on that after this video is over. I'm going to go back to my ligature because I just can't stand that ligature. So, oh well. This Jupiter, by the way, is the most expensive of the bunch. It's $69. $69 because it includes the ligature that I'm going to crush. And the cap, which goes with the ligature, you're paying for something that you're probably not going to use. But let's see what the mouthpiece sounds like on its own. This is the Van Doren Traditional 3. Pretty good, but the 3 is going to be too hard for most folks, I think. So I'm going to go down a half step to a 2.5. By the way, are you noticing that when I'm taking my reeds off and on, I'm not pulling the mouthpiece out? Why? Because that takes so much more time and I'm lazy. I'm putting the bass clarinet up in between my knees here, which is okay. It's not going to do any damage to the instrument. And that allows me to go ahead and move a reed on and off the mouthpiece, put it on, adjust it, and tighten the ligature without having to go through the process of taking the mouthpiece off and putting it back on, which puts stress on the neck. All right, this is a 2.5. All right, so that's too soft, but let me go ahead and sort of channel my low embouchure. It's kind of bright and edgy. Let me see if the Juno number 3 is a better option. Yeah. The Juno number 3 is the right reed for this Jupiter mouthpiece, I think. Noticing is that it gives me about 2 or 3 volumes. It's sort of forte, mezzo forte, and fuzz. If I push too hard and I want to get a fortissimo or something bigger than that, the reed closes off. Yeah, if I go to a forte, it sounds okay. If I go to a sort of mezzo forte, if I go to a piano, those are the 3 dynamics you get on the Jupiter. But if your music calls for mezzo forte or forte, you're golden. Now, last but not least, the mouthpiece I've been waiting for, the $20.19 no-name mouthpiece that I bought off of Amazon. All of the rest of the mouthpieces came in a box. This came in a Ziploc bag that says, made in China. That's all it said. If it doesn't work as a mouthpiece, you could use it as a nightlight. Soft embouchure. You know, to be honest with you, it feels almost identical to the Jupiter. And that starts to make me wonder if it is actually made in the same factory as the Jupiter. I'm going to take a closer look after I try this. 2.5. Yep, it feels exactly the same. The same issues with the 2.5 being too loose. Let me throw the Juno 3 on. Sound familiar? All right, I have to see. It's gonna be difficult for me to tell without any gauges, but I just have the suspicion. No, actually, it is a different mouthpiece. And the rails look like they haven't even been machined completely. This one rail over here, it's still shiny like it was molded, like it didn't finish going across the facer. It's actually rounded on one of the tip rails here. That's ridiculous. Okay, so let me wrap this up. The Chinese mouthpiece, that is not even in the consideration set, but the rest of them I have ranked from what I like least to best. The one that I like the least is the Yamaha 4C. It was very fuzzy and it didn't give me a lot of color at all. I also did not care for the Bundy mouthpiece. As you will remember, it had a long facing and I had to push on that reed in order to get a sound. Now that is something that your lip, as a young player, is not going to be able to do. So, and there's really nothing you can do about it except maybe sand the back of your reed. Good luck. But for the money, I wouldn't buy either of those two mouthpieces, even though those are kind of the name brands that probably most of you recognize. Next up in third place is the Premier by Height. This is an okay mouthpiece, though it didn't have a lot of color and I was having a difficult time matching a reed to it. The Premier by Height would be in third place there. Second place is the Jupiter, which kind of surprised me because I didn't think that was going to be super great. But it's $69 with a ligature that is completely useless that I've already crushed and thrown away. And I guess this mouthpiece cap, which would be useless without the ligature. At $69, this doesn't seem like the kind of value. I wouldn't necessarily go for this. And then in first place, the winner by a long shot, is the Clark Phobes debut at $56. The Clark Phobes debut is the one to beat as far as I'm concerned. It had a nice even sound. It was flexible with the reeds that I tried, so you could start with the 2.5, which I would recommend, or the Juno Strength 3. If you have to go up to a number 3 reed, think twice. You probably are playing on a reed that is too stiff for your mouthpiece. I would try to make it work with a 2.5 reed with this Clark Phobes debut. And at $56, it's quite a bargain. I'm very, very impressed with that mouthpiece. Rip the needle off the record because late this evening I got a delivery of a bunch of Bakun mouthpieces, and one of them was the Protégé, which retails around $55, $56, something like that. And so it fits into the category, and I didn't want to have to make another video later, so I'm going to do a last minute trial of the Bakun Protégé bass clarinet mouthpiece now to add along with the ones that you just saw. So let me give that a try with a number 3 first, like I did with the rest. So it's a little bit resistant with a number 3. Let me give it the loose embouchure. Yeah, it's too hard for a number 3. This is the Van Doren traditional 2.5. Let me try the Juno number 3 on it. Yeah, it's much better. Now, for me, the Juno, if I try to push too much air through it, it just stops, you know. You know, because it's such a soft reed. Which makes me believe, and I could be wrong here, that this is a fairly short facing, which means that the curve of the mouthpiece starts later, and with that combined with a softer reed means that it's easier to close the tip off. But hey, because we were comparing a moment ago, I'd like to put the Bakun up against the Height. Just to see how they compare to one another for a younger player who is looking for a mouthpiece that is relatively easy to play. So for me, the Height is much easier to play. If I was a younger student, that is. Right now, it's a little too easy for me to play. And it has more of a flat spread sound. It's not as pretty as the Bakun, but it is much easier to play. If I were to just sort of use a very loose embouchure. The sound comes out. If I were to do that on the Bakun, I don't think I would get the same kind of sound. I have to have more embouchure strength in order to produce a sound on the Bakun. And you know, I took a look at the two of these mouthpieces, and let me show you a picture here of the windows. That's the opening in the mouthpiece, and you can see that the Bakun has a significantly smaller window opening with thicker rails. And so the thicker rails mean more of the reed touches, which deadens the reed vibration. And if I look at it side by side, it looks like the Bakun mouthpiece is pretty flat, and then it scoops up at the very tip. So really only the tip of the reed is going to be able to do a lot of vibrating. That combination makes it harder to play. But I do notice that the sound that I get out of the Bakun is a rounder sound. It's just harder to get out. So I'm still going to say here that I'm going for the debut overall with the Bakun as a second. So now with all of that, thank you Bakun for getting this in at the last minute under the wire. And I hope this has been helpful for all of you. I will see you next time. Take care.